Well, Romanians are terrific in terms of business. They are smart, they're energetic, they truly are eager, but they are also impatient. And sometimes impatience can lead to building something that you see exists elsewhere in other countries, you see it online. It's a very good idea, it's a very good business idea, but it's not as simple as creating something that looks the same as it does elsewhere. It takes some patience, and I'm not talking about years of study, but a little bit of patience to first ask yourself some very fundamental questions as to what is the company, why should it exist here, what does it need to do, what's its mission, some really basic fundamental ideas. And until you have those, it's very easy to run around and create things that you're not sure why they don't succeed or why they never succeed as fully as they might otherwise. So the lesson needs to be learned, and I think you learn it best by example. And I think you need more examples here of mentoring or senior managers showing people the necessity for slowing down a little bit in the beginning, getting a fundamental understanding of what the business is about, and then letting your impatience take over and charge ahead and build and create your good ideas.
It's overestimated the role of expert in our corporate culture.
Well, again, first of all, you see that everywhere. You see experts being brought in to any situation in search of an answer. And the expectation that they will give you sort of the key three or four things to remember, then you can go home and do those. And it's never that simple. Again, it points to a bit of impatience that you have here, which is understandable given the 25 years or 20 years of real competitive business landscape that exists. You have an impatience about creating, building, being the first, being the biggest, and getting into the marketplace. So you try to take shortcuts, bringing in experts, bringing in trainers, bringing in lecturers that will give you sort of the short way of short-circuiting, if you will, the path to success. And you can't do it. You need to use the experts to bring back their information, but then start, as I say, understanding the real fundamentals of the definition of your business and the definition of what it is you're out to do.
Reading Plato did not qualify you for business, but if you are a businessman and you read Plato, you're gonna have an important advantage. Is this true?
There's a quote in there from American economist John Kenneth Galbraith that essentially says that if you are tied to Business Week, if that is your goal to become famous in Business Week, then you are a slave to fame. But if you read Proust, then you are destined for greatness. And that is whether you read Plato or Proust or others, to get a better understanding of society, the wants, the needs of people, the structure of society, how cultural influences can change the marketplace, then you can position yourself among the society into a role that becomes dominant and not simply serving kind of fast food left and right, but building a true operation that exists and succeeds and continues to succeed. And so whether it's Plato, it's up to you, but to read broadly and to understand human nature and where business fits into it and where you, your skills, create a business to take advantage of your skills, that then that business takes advantage of the current situation in society, all of that needs to come together, and you don't learn it just from a textbook or two.